We're standing on top of one of the two DOE-owned buoys that we have recently purchased for the purpose of acquiring information, meta-ocean information in our offshore wind areas across the U.S. It is a large vessel. It's about 20 feet in total length. And it's quite large for a variety of different reasons. It's meant to operate autonomously in the water for a significant period of time, and it's actually carrying a lot of different instrumentation within it. One of the key instruments that we have on top of this buoy is this LiDAR device here. The LiDAR is important for us because it provides high resolution information such as wind speed and wind direction at hundreds of feet. It can provide information at discrete elevations, which allows us to have higher confidence on what is the actual wind speeds that we can see that the wind turbine itself will be actually experiencing. This is really important in order for us to maximize the energy capture of the machines, as well as understanding the impacts of that resource in terms of reliability, operations, and other key conditions for the particular design of that wind plant. In addition to the LiDAR, we have some more traditional atmospheric measurement instruments. As you will see from the mast, we have a traditional cup, we have a vane, as well as a temperature sensor. The mast also carries a series of key instrumentations that provides GPS, so we know where the buoy is actually positioned, as well as some communications antenna that allows us to really transfer the information being recorded at the buoy to a nearshore site where the data can then be analyzed. In order to operate autonomously, this actual buoy is actually equipped with two different renewable options. First, you will see we actually have two photovoltaic panels. Each one of them are 220 watts, as well as a 1.1 kilowatt, 1.6 metered rotor wind turbine. Between these two technologies, as well as the onboard generator, we have the ability to operate in the ocean for several months without any human participation. On the deck, there are a series of hatches, which really lead to four distinct compartments within the buoy. In compartment four, we have a generator. In compartment three, we actually have the fuel tank for the generator. And in compartment two and one, we actually house all the critical information and the sensors that are really capturing all the information within the buoy. Why don't we take a look inside real quick? Within this compartment, there are a series of different instrumentations. Specifically, this box in front of you, the black box, is an accelerometer. And the reason the accelerometer is important is because it allows you to really resolve the wave conditions in the actual that the actual buoy is experiencing. This is important so we understand everything from wave heights, extreme conditions, etc. Again, these are the kinds of information that we need to drive and understand what the offshore wind facility will look like in the future. What we're trying to do is really understand the resource for offshore wind deployment. So we're really trying to really capture the type of information so we can do micro sighting of potential future wind plants. And the better you know the resource, i.e. how good the wind speeds are, how are the meadow ocean conditions such as the wave heights, etc., the better you can design a future offshore wind plant and the more energy you can capture from that particular site.